So a newly formed group of African-American business executives, CEOs, they're going to spend millions and millions of dollars in the upcoming midterms. It's the Black Economic Alliance. It has already raised about $3.5 million. They're raising more. They're officially a nonpartisan group. They are backing right now four Democrats in these first round of endorsements. And the co-chairman, the founder, Dr. Tony Coles, joins me. Nice to have you.
Thank you, Poppy. It's great to be here.
So thank you for joining me. And let's talk first about, and it's important to note, this is really the first time that we've seen Black American executives come together and say, we're going to put our power and our voice and our money behind these candidates. Your mission is to talk about and address economic issues facing particularly African Americans in this country. What is missing in that conversation right now?
Well, several of us have all written checks individually to support candidates, but this is really the first time that we've collectively come together and as a group to focus on economic progress for Black Americans. Mm-hmm. The statistics are critical. We know that even amongst adults, college-educated adults, Black Americans earn 25% less than white Americans. Even if you look at household net income, for instance, it's 60% lower in Black households. So we think that this is a critical moment in the conversation, particularly as the economy appears to be rebounding, for us to play a role and support this mission.
The four candidates right now that you guys have come out and endorsed, Senator Tim Kaine of Virginia, gubernatorial candidate in Georgia, Stacey Abrams, who'd be the first Black governor in the country, Ben Jealous in Maryland, Richard Cordray in Ohio. These are Democrats. You guys, I know, are going to back 10 to 15 for the midterms. Any Republicans you like? Any Republicans that might get your group support?
Well, for each one of the races we have an interest in, and it's certainly true in these cases, we have reached out to the Democratic candidates and the Republican candidates. To date, we've not been able to engage the Republican candidates in the races of interest, but we'd look forward to and we would welcome the opportunity to talk about the mission.
I mean, they're not responding? They don't want your support?
Well, I can't comment on why they might not have responded. All I can say is that we actually, because we're nonpartisan, we try very even-handedly to reach out to both sides. We're looking for tractable solutions that are that are pragmatic and that can be implemented. We don't think that that's a good idea, that's a Republican idea or a Democrat idea necessarily, but we're looking for the idea that will work and be most productive. It's what we as business people are trained to do. And so if there's a Republican candidate who believes in the mission, who wants to sponsor legislation to support economic progress, we'd be happy to engage and to endorse them.
You know, you have said, and let me quote here, it's critical we make Black economic progress part of the conversation. And the president often touts what he says his administration has done on that front for African Americans. Just listen to some of what he said.
And something I'm very proud of, African American unemployment stands at the lowest rate ever recorded.
And on the campaign trail, remember I said, and would constantly say, what do you have to lose? Meaning, what do you have to lose if you vote for Trump? And now, it was just reported, African American unemployment is at its lowest level in history.
Has he done enough? Does he have, do you think he should be patting himself on the back for this?
Well, it's true that the statistics suggest that this is the lowest unemployment level for Blacks in several years, perhaps since we've been keeping records. But if you just peel the layers of the onion back, and let me set that data into context, if I might. Black Americans still have the highest unemployment of all racial groups, white, Latino, and Hispanic, so there's a problem there, clearly.
Yeah.
And when we are employed, we're not in the high-skilled and high-paying jobs. We're about 13% of the population of this country, and we hold about 12% of the jobs in this country, but we only represent 6% of the tech jobs, which are widely regarded as the new economy and growth opportunity jobs.
Of course.
So correcting that imbalance, I think, is going to be quite important, and we're looking for candidates who will be proactive and support opportunities for African Americans to participate in the American dream. I think that's all anyone wants.
Yeah, indeed. Equality. Tony Coles, it's fascinating what you're doing. Please keep us posted on what you hear back from the other candidates you've reached out to. Thanks for being here.